Hello YouTube, Sticks and Seams 2.5 here again with another video. I figure just kind of go for it. Wanted to do a little different of a showcase today. I'm going to show off my Hall of Fame autographs. They're all single signed autographs. For those of you who have watched my previous video or tuned into Mr. Fisher Bike's video, I do have those 05 Ultimate Duels. I'm going to save that for its own showcase, so obviously there are a lot of Hall of Famers on those that I'm not including here, but I just wanted to kind of get it out there, a little bit of Hall of Fame action here. I do have much more autos with regard to Hall of Famers, but it's all on memorabilia, which we'll save that for another time, but just wanted to also thank all those people out there that are showing their support for me. Been on YouTube for, I guess, less than 72 hours. I already have 20 subs. I'll take it. I'm going to start off. There's no particular order here. I just kind of tried to group them all out and pull them from different places. So first up, we'll start with Topps 5-star. Got Al Kaline. These 5-star autographs are really, really nice. Got a Lou Brock, number to 299. My only Bagwell auto. This is probably my least favorite design of all the 5-stars. This silver, I think it confused a lot of the players too, because I've seen them sign above that. Jim Rice. This card's awesome. Number to 25, Pedro Martinez, Heart of a Champion. And yes, I will put those in mags. I just don't have them at that size yet. Edgar Martinez. I think that one's number to 386. And Paul Molitor, also number to 386. Hop around. These are Topps tributes. The Shadow Box. These things are amazing. I got the Yastrzemski. They're all hand numbered. This one's numbered to 25. It's an orange parallel, I guess. I got the purple parallel of Glavin, numbered to 50. And I guess this might just be a base version, numbered to 99 of Paul Molitor. These cards are really, really nice. That was a wise decision. Let's see, I got a Topps Triple Threads, Vlad the Impaler. Couple pinstripes in there, but I'm not huge on the jersey cards, but 2 of 18. Johnny Schmoltz. Carlton Fisk. That's Topps Tier 1, I think. Another Topps Tier 1. Jim, I'm just doing what they told me. Little Dynasty action. Pedro in the Montreal uniform. Those cards are amazing. You're just better off buying the card for the price of the box for its crapshoot. Biggio. 6 of 10. It's a pretty nice patch on that. It looks like a letter patch. I got a Tim Rock Reigns SP Legendary Cuts, number 25, Legendary Lineage. Topps Finest Hour, Ricky Henderson. This card's really cool. It's the only Ricky auto I own. A lot of these guys, I have autos on balls, jerseys, bats, but that's the only one I own. Greg Maddux. I don't remember if this is Topps Tech or there's a couple of them that are out there like this. Little Sweet Spot, Bobby Doerr. Y'all, if you watch my previous video, you've seen this one, the Sweet Spot Griffey on the inscription. And I have a Nolan Ryan, 56 out of 80. It's a really nice card. That is my only Nolan Ryan autograph. This is from Definitive Collection, and obviously y'all know what an expensive product that is, and I don't see why people buy it. I get it, you're chasing the hits, and if you got the money to burn, might as well let it burn. But I purchased a few of these cards for less than $25, and I want to say the boxes were upwards of 1,000. I got Pudge Rodriguez in a Rangers uniform out of 40 with a jersey piece. Robin Yount dual pinstripe jersey. This one's out of 25. Got a tier one Ryan Sandberg out of 25. A Strata Jimmy Mench. This one has like an acetate window here. Cool card. Different. I pulled this one myself back in the day with Top Sterling. Actually, I really did bust quite a little bit of Top Sterling now that I look back at it. But it's a 3 of 10 Yogi Berra Auto dual bat dual pinstripe jersey. Got a Museum Collection Billy Williams. Got a few cuts here. SP Legendary Cuts 04 Joe Sewell. These cards are just really cool. I really like those. Looks like that one was a canceled check. This is just probably an index card of some sorts. This is Luke Appling. And one of my first big baseball card purchases when I got back into it. Couple years back now. Also SP Legendary Cuts, Red Sox great Joe Cronin. You all saw this one yesterday if you watched my other video, Griffey. I got an Ultimate Bobby Dor. I got a buyback auto from Upper Deck, Reggie Jackson. Remember these inserts? Kirby Puckett. It is embossed, the certificate of authenticity. It's from scoreboard, I believe. This is a really nice card. Tom Seaver from the Hawaii Conference, hand numbered 164 out of 500. It's just a cool card. Funny story about that. I actually went to college in Hawaii and did not collect then, and I lived less than 50 yards from the convention center where they held those, so go figure. This was a Topps Heritage Malai 11. That was last year's Heritage. It's a nice card, nice clean blue auto. I got a Millennium Marks Eddie Murray. Mine's numbered 724. Got an Ultimate Jack Morris. I got a Topps Tier 1 Frank Thomas numbered out of 60. And I'm not exactly sure what these are. I think it was exclusive. You could buy it from Upper Deck Online. It's a Reggie Jackson that came with a promo card, like a dealer sample, the autograph card. It is Upper Deck authenticated, and he's not in a Yankees uniform, so that was a good win for me, for the price especially. I think the whole thing shipped with one of those large screw downs was like $18, $20, so can't go wrong there. So these are some of the heavier hitters as far as the cards. I actually watched a video of baseball collector Mike, and he pulled this. I guess it's one of the top 500 cards or whatever. Thomas Paine, 300 cards, I guess. I'm looking at the book over there. The Joe DiMaggio Pinnacle signature set. I think I got a steal on that. I bought the whole thing tin with a sleeve and all for less than $100, so I think I did pretty well. This is a beauty. Mike O sees this, he'll like this one. It's a 13 Allen Ginter Mini PSA 10 Auto Mariano Rivera. And I also purchased a Chipper Jones Auto Topps Rookie. I got the Johnny Pesky This card's awesome. It's a Legends booklet Panini. Not a big Panini guy, but they did a good job with these booklet cards. The needle. I got one Perez Steel, Lou Boudreau. These are really nice too, and they look nice displayed when they're slabbed. I have the Bobby Doerr Hall of Fame postcard. And I have a Beckett authenticated cut of longtime Red Sox broadcaster and Hall of Famer, a Frick Award winner as well, and I think like 84, Kurt Gowdy. So that's pretty much it for my auto cards for Hall of Famers. As you can see up here, you get a little glimpse of some of my memorabilia. These four bats are all Cooperstown. Yastrzemski on an All-Star 99 Fenway. Nomar on a Boston bat. This one is Carlton Fisk. This one is Sandy Koufax. This beauty is a Ken Griffey Jr. Upper Deck authenticated 99 All-Star Game commemorative bat. And there we go. That is a George Brett Gamer. I'm 100% convinced it's a gamer. My dad actually got that from somebody who owned a bar in the Kansas City area that George Brett used to go to all the time in the 80s, signed. I had a jersey at one point as well, but I've gotten rid of that. It was pretty damaged from smoke from the bar. It was yellowed, but I kept the bat. Bat looks really good. So that's it. Hope you liked what I had to show you. If you like it, please comment below. And keep looking out for more content. Eventually, I think my next showcase, I'll do the 05 Ultimate Duels. But again, thanks a lot. Sticks and Seams 2-5 out.